Shalom Israel partners, Shalom House of Destiny, and welcome to Israel. I'm standing here right in the middle of a wheat field on the soil of Israel, obviously. And today's teaching is about probably the most important time in the Jewish calendar. I mean, as in terms of a season. This is probably the most important season in the Jewish calendar. When the 7 days of Passover ended, this is where we end the commemoration and the remembrance time of when God delivered the Jewish people from slavery in Egypt. And we're literally entering into the 7 weeks, the 49 days, until the 50th day, which is the day of Pentecost. Or in Hebrew, the name is Shavuot. 7 weeks means Sheva Shavuot, 49 days. And this period of time is a period of time where a Jew and his family are commanded to go up in the elevation of their encountering time with God, with the Lord God of Israel. After we remember the deliverance from slavery, when God literally delivered our physical body from slavery, this is the time that we are reaching towards the spiritual deliverance of the Jewish people into their faith, and into the acceptance of God's rules and laws in our lives. So the holiday of Shavuot or Pentecost is, according to the Jewish tradition, the time when God gave us the 5 books of Moses, as we call them, the Torah, on Mount Sinai. And a period of time that we were delivered from the physical slavery in Egypt, and day by day, we in the Jewish tradition counting the days of the Omer, we're counting each and every day as a mounting up the scale towards the 50th day, which is the peak and the highlight of this season of time. This very season of time is a time when a person and his family, while they're working in the fields, they have to actually pay attention and understand the amazing blessing that God has given us once He brought us from slavery in Egypt into our liberation, into our promised land, when we are masters for our own fate and for our own destiny. We grow our own crops. We live in our own land. We are in a situation when now we have to provide for ourselves. You know, and I'm trying to explain to you maybe in a syndrome that some of you knows. You know probably the syndrome of the convict. If somebody has been jailed for so many years in prison, and many people, while they get out of prison, after they finish their term, and they want to go back to the normal life, they find it almost impossible. They don't even remember the rules outside. They don't know how to act outside. They don't know how even to start finding themselves a job, a work, to do even anything outside, because they are so used to the routine of the jail. That's the same story of the people of Israel. After 400 years in the jail of the Egyptians in slavery, they never even understand what it means to be free men, free people. And we remember throughout the desert, even though God provided them with the money and with the waters and everything, they still were complaining to Moses. They wanted to go back to the meat pot in Egypt, even though they were slaves, but then they knew the rules. Just like prisoners, they know that in the end of the day, they'll have a hot meal or somebody will feed them. That's the thing that God wanted us to get free of, this mental state of mind of slavery. And that's why every day in the freedom, we're counting it out loud. We're counting every day of these 49 days as our new era, our new time of freedom. And after God delivered us from that time, we, on the second day of Passover, we are bringing the first crops of the barley to the temple as a love grain offering to God, that He took our bodies out of slavery and He took it into freedom. The barley represents food, but not very much food for the people. It's more considered to be, in the Jewish tradition, the food for the animals. And therefore, our working personality, the animal in us, was freed, but our brains, our spirit is not freed yet. The second day of Passover, the Jewish people go up on their pilgrimage and they bring to the holy temple, to the holy priests at the temple, they bring them the love grain offering in the shape of green barley, this color of a green barley. They bring it and they say to the people at the temple, here we are acknowledging that we are starting our journey into freedom. So that's the offering that we give on the Passover. And every day between Passover going into the times of Pentecost, we go on and we examine the sides of the wheat in our fields. Now we're talking about wheat, not about barley, and we see that it's becoming browner and browner until in Shavuot everything is ripe, it's ready to be harvested, and it's ready to be given to God in the shape of bread. Already the product, the ready-made product that comes out of the wheat, we bring two loaves of bread up to the temple together with our first fruits and together with the best crops that we have for this year, acknowledging God's provision and protection over us when we are becoming a person that from a taker, somebody that was provided for throughout the desert, into somebody that took possession of the land and is able to even provide for his own family and for others. In the Jewish tradition, the laws of Moses, what God gave us on Mount Sinai, the Torah, these are the rules that the Jewish people accepted in order to be also in alignment with God, not only in the free body, but also in the free spirit. Also, after learning the rules, studying them very carefully, understanding that we accept them because we know that this is the source of our blessing if we are going to fulfill God's commitment in our lives, the 613 commandments that God has given us. When we accept it, then we are free in spirit and in the body. We have to understand these rules are not easy rules to fulfill. And sometimes we even change some things. We sometimes don't fill up everything. But the counting of the days with anticipation to get to the day of Shavuot, the festival of the weeks, the festival of Pentecost, when even in the Christian tradition we know that during Pentecost, this is when the Holy Spirit came down to the world. That's the Judeo-Christian heritage. In alignment together, we know that only when God is present in our midst, this is when we are whole and complete. It's not that we can find something to eat. The way God wants us to go, the journey that He wants us to go into, is becoming from takers into givers, from people who are provided for into people that are providing to others. And this we demonstrate by a very special rule and routine that we take upon ourselves and pledges that we take upon ourselves. You know that the entire month before the Passover, every Jewish person is working very hard in all kinds of different jobs, doing the spring cleaning, preparing our bodies to the time when God is going to come in our midst and we celebrate the Seder, we celebrate this beautiful supper, and we go to the temple and we bring the first crops offering of our grains, saying thank you God for delivering us from slavery. But now, during these 5 weeks, and then into the 7th weeks, until the 33rd day, and from the 33rd to the 49th day after Lag BaOmer, this is when we are working extra hard and walking the extra mile in order to get it together, a nickel to a dime, looking at the best crops of our fields and the best of the best we put aside and we dedicate it to God. We take it and we say to ourselves and we testify in front of the witnesses, the Kohanim, the priests in the temple, that everything belongs to God and everything comes from God. We're taking our tithes, the best tithing we have, and we give it to the priests at the temple, even though everybody would like to eat the bigger fruit, everybody would like to have the wonderful steak, everybody would like to enjoy the best wine. No, we say the best of the best is going to God, to the Lord God of Israel. Should He not given us the Torah and the people of Israel watching over the five books of Moses and the laws of Moses? We watch over the Torah so closely and firmly because we believe as long as we watch over and keep the Torah is going to protect us just like God promised us. He said, should you give me the first crops, should you fulfill my commandments, I will always protect you, always provide for you, always bring you the rain in its time. Always will let you harvest your field, will protect your boundaries and borders from the enemies. And here we are, standing in a beautiful, thriving field behind me. Look at this. It's an ocean of wheat that in the heart of the farmer, or you think of now, in this 7 weeks, what best part of my field I'm going to get together into a huge pile, that's what we call Omer, La'amor Omarim, take the biggest pile you can take in your hands, put it on the back of your mule, and this most amazing huge pile you take, you make it into the best, big, tastiest bread you can bake, and you bring it with you, two huge loaves of bread to the temple. Then the Kohanim will deliver it and give it to the poor people of your nation that cannot have a field like yours. You acknowledge that the source of your blessing is coming from the Lord God of Israel. Can you imagine how unselfish you are when you are looking at the best of the best of the crops and you make a decision in your mind, this is not mine. This belongs to my God. And through God to the poor people of my country, of my state, of the people of Israel. That's the ultimate altruism. The biggest sacrifice is to give away. And you know, that's what's happening in our tradition. Before Passover, we buy the best things we can buy. We put down the best party we can do, the best meal we can do. We take all the money that we have. We literally empty the bucket in order to give glory to God that He delivered us from slavery. Now that the bucket is empty and we're starting to see the crops growing in our fields, we're not filling up immediately the bucket. That would be the right instinct and the first instinct for everybody. I emptied my bucket, I want to fill it up right now. No, we're still thinking about first and foremost, we're going to give more. We do the extra. Even the bucket is empty, because we know that God can only fill up an empty bucket. And in these 7 weeks, when all our mindset is how to give more to God, this is when our hearts are so pure in doing this that God examines us from the inside out, and He knows for sure this person who thinks about how can I help the others, he is entitled, she is entitled to get my blessing. And can you imagine the beautiful, beautiful, beautiful crops and the amazing harvest that you're going to reap after you have taken what the sows that you have sown and you have harvested the first crops, you give it to God and to the poor people, how many hundredfolds more you'll be blessed for doing this. That's exactly House of Destiny and Israel Partners, that's what you're doing. You are sowing a seed into the land of God, into the people of God. In unselfish way, you say to yourselves, I know that God blessed me with abundance. I want to take some of it and I want to give it to people who doesn't have. I want to buy a bomb shelter in Israel and provide for the Jewish people that they occupied and hold on to the promised land, to the land of our rapture, until time will come for all of us to get into our rapture. This remnant of the Jewish people that holding on to the promised land doesn't let the enemy and Satan's and the devils that are eyeing and plotting against this land to take it over and contaminate it so we cannot get to rapture and get to our deliverance. That's the beautiful thing that you're doing. You're building a bomb shelter so we can protect the country. You're giving You're giving your offerings to the poor people, to the needy ones, to Holocaust survivors, to people that are holding on to the promise of God. And together, we will all reach this time when we'll be blessed, when Messiah will come. We will live our permanent life in righteousness after enjoying the fruits of our deliverance. That's what we're doing here together. We give you a channel through this beautiful Israel channel. We give you a channel to foresee your amazing future in the walk that you walk with Jesus and with the Lord God of Israel. That's a beautiful thing that we are so happy to provide to all our followers. This incredible channel, this route, this path, this trail that we can walk together and say and understand the times and the seasons of God and know what to do and how to sow into God's promises in our lives. Thank you for everything that you're doing for us. You are the ones that enables us to go where the rubber meets the road, where the needs is vast and great, to go and bless Israel and to be blessed so many times in return. I love you a lot. For the wheat fields of Israel, Doobie Sabbo. I'll see you soon.
Thank you for watching our YouTube channel. Remember to like and share this video. And if you're interested in donating to our ministry, the information is all in the description below. If you want to watch any of our past videos, click there. If you want to watch any of our new videos, click there.